Hi, my dear children. I am Geeta Priya. I am your maths teacher. How are you, children? I hope you all fine. Take care of your health, children. Okay, be safe at home. In today's class, we are going to revise the concept addition. Okay, children? In today's class, we are going to revise the concept addition. Yes, see here, in revision session we are going to discuss about addition symbol and addition using number string, addition by counting forward, vertical addition, horizontal addition, adding three one digit numbers, some story sums, properties of addition. Are you clear, children? What are we going to do in this session? Yes, let's start the class with an activity. Okay, now we are going to read the numbers 1 to 20. Read with me, children. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Super, children. You are reading the numbers very nicely. Shall we move on to the concept? Yes, I hope you are remembering the symbol for addition. What it is? This is the symbol for addition. Have you all remembered it? Yes, we read the symbol as plus. What's the addition symbol? This is the addition symbol. We read the symbol as plus. Yes, children. Now we are going to do an activity before move on to the next topic. Are you ready, children? Yes, come and do the activity. Now you are going to count and add the given object. What are these? These are cupcakes. How many cupcakes are given to you? Count and add. Yes, 1, 2 cupcakes and one more cupcake is added. What's the answer? 3. Very good. 2 plus 1 is 3. Super, children, you are telling the answer correctly. Now we are going to recall the concept addition using a number strip. Shall we move? Yes. Now we are going to recall this with an example. See here, for example, we are taking the number 3 and 4. Here we are going to add 3 and 4. Are you ready, children? Yes. Using the number strip, you have to write the number strip. The first step is to start from the first number. What's the first number in the question, children? Yes, 3 is the first number. First step is to, you have to start from the 3 and you have to jump 4 steps forward. Why we are in jump forward? Why are we jumping forward? Because we are doing addition. For addition, we have to jump forward. Are you remembering? Yes. Why are we jump 4 steps forward? Because we are adding 4 to the number 3. That's why we are start from the number 3 and we have to jump 4 steps forward. Are you clear? Shall we do? Yes. Come on. Now we are start from the number 3 and we have to jump 4 steps forward. Where we reach? Where do we reach, children? Yes, we reach the number 7. Thus, 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. Are you clear, children? Shall we do one more example? Yes, see here. For this, I am taking 1 and 5. We are going to add the numbers 1 and 5 using the number strip. Here, the number strip is given to you. Where do we start? Yes, we have to start from the first number. What is the first number in the given question? Yes, 1 is the first number. So, we are going to start from the number 1. What we are going to do? We are going to jump 5 steps forward. Clear with these steps, okay? Only 2 steps are there. Start from the number 1 and jump forward 5 steps, okay? Jump 5 steps forward. Yes, we are starting from 1 and we are jumping 5 steps forward. Where do we reach, children? Yes, we reach the number 6. Thus, 1 plus 5 is equal to 6. We are getting the answer. Are you clear with this? Are you clear with the addition using number strip? I We have start from the number 11 and we have to move two steps forward and count. What will we get? What we reach? Yes, we reach the number 13. Thus, 11 plus 2 equal to 13. Are you clear with these steps? Shall we see one more example? Yes, see here. The second example is we are going to add the number 17 and the number 3. Are you ready, children? Very simple two steps are given to you. Okay. See the question and mark. Take the number first. Okay. You have to start from the first number. What is the first number? 17 is the first number. That's why we are starting from the number 17. What are we going to next? Next we are going to count. We are going to move three steps forward. Why are we moving forward? Because we are doing addition. Keep these things in your mind. Then it will be very easy for you to do add sums. Okay. Now we are starting from the number 70 and we are going to move three steps forward and count to get the answer. Yes, children. Very good. After 70, we are moving three steps forward and count. Where do we reach, children? Now where do we reach? Yes, we reach the number 20. Thus, 70 plus 3 is equal to 20. Are you clear with this? Yes, I hope. Now we are going to recall vertical addition of two numbers. Have you all remembering this? Yes. Let us do some examples. Okay. It will be better for you. Shall we do? Yes. See here. Now we are going to do some examples for vertical addition of two numbers. Are you ready, children? Yes. The first problem is we are going to add 2 and 4. What is the question? Listen to the question carefully. We are going to add 2 and 4. For vertical addition, step 1 is to arrange the numbers vertically. Listen my words carefully, okay? First step is to arrange the given numbers in vertical. Okay, what are the given numbers? 2 and 4. We are going to arrange the given numbers 2 and 4 in vertical order. Why are we putting the plus symbol? Because we are doing addition. Keep these things in your mind. For vertical addition, first step is to arrange the given numbers vertically. We done the first step. Now we move on to the next step. Keep the first number in your mind. What is the first number? Here the number is 2. Keep the number 2 in your mind and take 4 fingers, count forward. Okay, to get answer, keep the number 2 in your mind, take 4 fingers and count forward. After 2, what will come? 3, 4, 5, 6. Where do we reach? We reach the number 6. Thus, what's the answer? 2 plus 4, we are getting 6. Are you clear, children? Shall we move to the next problem? Yes. See the sums carefully, okay? The second sum is add 1 and 4. Now we are going to add the numbers 1 and 4. We are doing vertical addition. For vertical addition, first step is to arrange the given numbers vertically. Okay, are you clear? Arrange the given numbers vertically. 1 and 4. Why are we putting the plus symbol? Because we are doing addition. Okay, keep these things in your mind. Now we are going to add given two numbers by counting forward. Are you ready, children? Yes. Keep the number 1 in your mind. Keep the number 1 in your mind. Take 4 fingers in your hand and count forward. What will come after 1? 2, 3, 4, 5. Where do we reach, children? Yes, we reach the number 5. Yes, we get the answer. 1 plus 4 equal to 5. Super, children. We have one more problem to do. The third sum is add 3 and 4. Now we are going to add the number for vertical addition, we have to arrange the given numbers vertically. We have to arrange the given numbers vertically. That's it for step one. Arrange the given numbers vertically. For addition, we are putting the plus symbol. Now we are going to add by counting forward. Are you clear, children? Yes. Keep the number 3 in your mind. Take 4 fingers and count forward. After 3, what will come? Yes, super. 4, 5, 6, 7. That do we reach, children? Yes, we reach the number 7. That's 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. We have one more problem, children. Shall we do it? Yes. Now we are going to do fourth sum. The given numbers are 6 and 1. Now we are going to add the numbers 6 and 1. For vertical addition, there are only two simple steps. First step is to arrange the given numbers vertically. Okay? Arrange the given numbers vertically and put plus symbol for addition. Are you okay? Shall you want to the second step? Yes. Step 2 is to keep the number 6 in your mind and take one finger. Keep the number 6 in your mind and take one finger. Count forward. After 6, what will come? Yes, 7 will come. Where do we reach? We reach number 7. Write the answer here. Thus, we getting the answer 7 by adding 6 and 1. I hope, children, you having better knowledge in vertical addition of two numbers. Shall we move on to the another concept? Come on. Now we are going to recall horizontal addition of two numbers. Till now what we are doing? Vertical addition of two numbers. Read the questions carefully, children, and remembering the steps, okay? Now we are going to recall horizontal addition of two numbers. Shall we do some problems in this? Yes, let's come on. What are we going to do? Now we are going to do some problems for horizontal addition. Shall we start? Yes, first sum is add number 10 and 2. Add the numbers 10 and 2. First sum is to add the numbers 10 and 2. What we are doing? We are doing horizontal addition. So keep this mind. There is only two simple steps. First step is to arrange the given numbers horizontally. For horizontal addition, first step is to arrange the given numbers in horizontally. Okay? Shall we do? Yes. 10 plus 2. This is horizontal. Okay? This is the horizontal format. Why we are putting plus symbol here? Because we are doing addition. Keep these things in your mind. First step is over. Now we are going to the second step. Keep the number 10 in your mind. Take two fingers in your hand and count forward. What number will come after 10? 11, 12. Where do we reach? We reach the number 12. Write the answer 12. Is it okay, children? There are only two steps. The difference between the vertical and horizontal addition is only arranging the numbers. Okay, for vertical addition, we are arranging the given numbers vertically. For horizontal addition, we are arranging the numbers horizontally. That's it. Other steps are same. Okay, shall we move on to the second sum? Yes. The second sum is to add the numbers 8 and the number 3. Are you ready, children? Now we are going to add numbers 8 and 3 horizontally. Okay. For horizontal addition, we have to arrange the given numbers horizontally. Then put the plus symbol for addition. Shall we do it? Next step is to keep the number 8 in your mind. Take 3 fingers in your hand. Count forward. After 8, what will come? 11, 12, 9. 9, 10, 11. Where do we reach? We reach the number 11 by adding the numbers 8 and 3. Are you clear, children? Yes, super. Now we are going to do one more sum. Okay. Here we are going to add the numbers 6 done for you, children. Yes, we done the first step. Second step is to super. Keep the number 6 in your mind and take 7 fingers in your hand. 7 fingers in your hand. Count forward to get the answer. After 6, what will come? 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. What? Where do we reach? We reach the number 13. Thus, by adding 6 and 7, we are getting the answer 13. Are you clear with the addition? Are you clear with the horizontal addition, children? Yes, I hope. Now we are moving to the next concept, children. Yes, now we are going to recall addition of 3 1-digit numbers. Till now we are recalling and done some sums in addition of 2 numbers. Here we are moving to addition of 3-digit numbers. Are you ready, children? As 2 numbers, we can add 3-digit numbers horizontally as well as vertically. First, we are going to revise horizontal method. See the example problem. First step is to arrange the given numbers in horizontal order. Arrange the given numbers in horizontal order. Okay, like this you have to arrange the given numbers horizontally. Here we have 3 numbers. So the steps are different. Okay, see carefully. First we have to add first 2 numbers. Step 1 is to add first 2 numbers. What are the first 2 numbers? Yes, 3 and 2 are first 2 numbers in the given question. Now we are going to add these 2 numbers. Are you clear with this? Yes. What's the answer? Yes, we are getting 5 by adding 3 and 2. And write the third number here. And also write the third number here. Now we have 2 numbers to add. Add and write the answer. 5 plus 1 equal to 6. Keep the number 5 in your mind. And take one finger in your hand. Count forward. What will come after 5? 6. That's why we are writing the answer 6. Listen me carefully. For adding 3 1-digit numbers horizontally, listen the word horizontally. First step is to arrange the given numbers horizontally. That's it. Step 2 is add the first 2 numbers and write the answer. You also have to write the third number. And add these 2 numbers and write the answer. Are you clear, children? Shall we do some sums for a better practice? Yes. Come on. See here, children. First we are going to add numbers 2, 3 and 4. This is your sum for horizontal addition of 3 1-digit numbers are doing. Okay. Add 2, 3 and 4. First step for horizontal addition. First step is to arrange the given numbers horizontally. Arrange the given numbers horizontally. Then put plus symbol. Why are we putting the plus symbol? Because we are doing addition. Okay. Are you clear with this? Now we are moving to the second step. Second step is to add the first 2 numbers. What are the first 2 numbers? 2 and 3. Now we are going to add 2 and 3. As usual, keep the number 2 in your mind and take 3 fingers in your hand. Count forward. After 2, what will come? 3, 4, 5. What's the answer by adding 2 and 3? We are getting 5 as answer. Now you have to write the third number here. You have to write the third number here. Again, we have 2 numbers to add it. Keep the number 5 in your mind and take 4 fingers. Count forward. After 5, what will come? 6, 6, 7, 8, 9. Where do we reach? We reach the number 9. Yes, by adding 2, 3, 4 horizontally, we are getting the answer 9. Are you clear, children? Shall we do one more sum? Yes, see here. Second sum. Add 7, 3 and 5. Now we are going to add 7, 3, 5 horizontally. For horizontal addition. first step is to arrange the given three numbers correspondingly. Are you clear with this? Yes. First we are going to arrange the given numbers correspondingly and put plus symbol for doing addition. The second step is to add the first two numbers. What is the second step? Second step is to add the first two numbers. Are you ready, children? Add and tell me the answer. Yes, 7 plus 3 is equal to 10. How are you getting? Yes, keep the number 7 in your mind and take 3 fingers. Come forward. After 7, 8 will come, 9, 10. You have to write the third number here. Now you are having two numbers to add. Add this and write the final answer. Add 10 and 5. Keep the number 10 in your mind and take 5 fingers. Count forward. After 10, what will come? 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Where do we reach, children? Yes, we are reaching the number 15. Thus, by adding 7, 3 and 5, we are getting the answer 15. Are you clear, children? Are you clear with the horizontal addition of 3 one-digit numbers? I hope, children, keep practicing, okay? For better understanding, you need some more practice, okay? Practice daily. Yes, now we are going to revise adding 3 one-digit numbers vertically. Are you ready, children? Adding 3 one-digit numbers vertically. Let's do the example, okay? Here we have numbers 4, 2, 3. We are adding 4, 2, 3. For vertical addition, we are arranging the numbers vertically. Are you clear with it? Now we are moving to the step 1. Step 1 is to add first two numbers. Okay. Same step in the horizontal. Only the difference arrangement of numbers. Okay. For vertical addition, we are arranging the given numbers vertically. That's it. The second step is same. Add first two numbers and write the answer in the circle. 4 plus 2. What's the answer? 6 is the answer. Step 2 is to add the number in the circle and the third number. 6 plus 3. What's the answer? 9 is the answer. Very good, children. Now it's time to practice some more problems for better understanding. Shall we do? Yes. Come on. Now we are going to do vertical addition of 3 one-digit numbers. For that we are going to practice some problems. And question is, add 2, 4 and 3. Clear with the question? We are going to add 2, 4 and 3 vertically. Okay. First step for vertical addition. To arrange the numbers, given numbers in the vertical order. Arrange the given numbers in vertical order. Why are we putting the plus symbol? For doing addition. Are you clear, children? Shall we move to the next step? Yes, put the circle here. First step, second step is to add the first two numbers. Now we are going to add 2 and 4 as usual. Keep the number 2 in your mind. Take 4 fingers, count forward. After 2, what will come, children? Yes, very good. 3 will come. 3, 4, 5 and 6. Where do we reach? We reach the number 6. Write the answer by getting this 2, okay? Here, you have to write the answer here. The third step is to, now we are going to add the number in the circle and the third number. 6 and 3, we are going to add 6 and 3. Keep the number 6 in your mind and take 3 fingers, count forward. After 6, what will come, children? 7, 8, 9. What's the answer? 9 is the answer. Are you clear? Shall we move to the next sum? Yes. Listen the second sum. Add 1, 4 and 2. For vertical addition, we are taking the sum 1, 4, 2. First step is to read the question vertical. So we are arranging the given numbers vertically and put plus symbol for doing addition. Are you clear, children? Are you okay? Follow me. First step is to add the first two numbers and write the answer in this 1 plus 4, what's the answer? Yes, 5 is the answer. Keep the number 1 in your mind and take 4 fingers. 1 plus 4, 5. Now we are going to add this number and this number. 5, 1, 2. Keep the number 5 in your mind and 2 in your hands. Count forward. After 5, what will come? 5, 6, 7. Where do we reach? We reach the number 7. One more problem is for you. Now we are going to add the numbers 2, 3 and 4. Okay, we are going to add the numbers 2 and 4. See here, in first sum we are adding 2, 4 and 3. In third sum we are adding 2, 3 and 4. Okay, first step for vertical addition is to arrange the numbers in vertical order. Now we are arranging the given numbers in vertical order. Second step is to add the first two numbers as usual. Keep the number 2 in your mind and take 3 fingers, count forward. After 2, 3, 4, 5. Where do we reach? We reach the number 5. Write the answer in the circle. Third step is to add the number in the circle and the third number. Are you clear? Listen my words carefully. Now we are adding the number in the circle and the third number. And as usual, keep the number 5 in your mind and take 4 fingers. Count forward. 6, 7, 8, 9. What's the answer? 9. Yes, we are getting the answer 9 by adding 2, 3 and 4 vertically. Super children. Shall we move on to the next concept? Yes, now we are going to recall properties of addition. What are we going to do? Now we are going to do recall properties of addition. How many properties are there? Yes, there are three properties in addition. The first property is adding 0, next adding 1, next order property in addition. Shall we recall it one by one? Yes. See here. Adding 0. When 0 is added to a number, the answer is always the same. There is no change in the answer. Okay. See the example. Here we are adding 4 lemons and 0 lemons. What are we doing? Here we are adding 0 lemons means there is no lemon. 0 lemons to 4 lemons. What's the answer? The answer remains same. Answer is 4 lemons, children. Are you clear? Yes. Now you have one activity. Fill the blanks. Yes. How many apples are there? Yes. 5 apples are there. Is there any apple? No. Then write 0 apples. Here we are adding 0 apples to 5 apples. What is the answer, children? Yes. We are getting the answer 5 apples. There is no change in the answer. See here, when 0 is added to a number, the answer is 1. Yes, second property is adding 1. Listen the words carefully. When 1 is added to a number, the answer is always the number that comes just after. I hope you all knowing the meaning of just after. See the example. Here we are adding 1 parachute to 4 parachutes. What are we doing? We are adding 1 parachute to 4 parachutes. What's the answer? 5. What's the 5? 5 is nothing but this is number that comes just after number 4. 5 is the number that comes just after number 4. Are you clear, children? Now it's time to do an activity. Count the number of strawberries and fill in the blanks. Are you ready, children? Are you finding? Yes, tell me the answer. How many strawberries are there? Yes, here 6 strawberries. How many strawberries? Yes, here there is a 1 strawberry. What's the answer? Yes, very good. 7 strawberries. By adding 1 and 6, we are getting the answer 7. 7 is nothing but the number that comes just after number 6. This is the property. Adding 1. Okay. Are you clear, children? Shall we move on to the third property? Yes. if their order is changed. Read it carefully. When we add the numbers, even if their order is changed, the answer remains the same. Are you okay, children? See the example. First, we are adding 4 red apples to the 2 green apples. What's the answer? We are getting the answer 6. See the second one. Here we are adding 2 green apples to 4 red apples. What's the answer? Again we are getting the 6 as answer. The answer is not changed. The answer is remains when the order is changed. Even the order of numbers change, the answer remains same. Are you clear, children? Now we are going to see one more example. These are candies. First we are adding 5 candies to 3. What's the answer? We are getting 8. Here, see here, we are adding 3 candies to 5. What's the answer? Again we are getting the answer 8. There is no change in the answer. Even the order of numbers are changed. Okay, see here, here we write 5 and 3. Here we add 3 and 5. The order of numbers are changed, but the answer is same. Shall we do an activity? Yes. Now it's your turn to answer. You have to fill this blanks. Okay. How many green apples are there? Yes, 2 green apples. How many red apples are there? 3. Add 2 and 3 and tell me the answer. Yes, very good. You are telling the answer correctly. Now do the second one. How many green apples are there? 3 green apples. How many red apples are there? 2. Add these 2. 3 plus 2. What's the answer? Very good, children. We are getting the same answer. Even the order of number changed. Here we are adding 2 and 3. Here we are adding 3 and 2. But there is no change in the answer. This is order property addition. I hope you all have a better understanding in properties of addition. Now it's time to move story sums. Now we are going to recall some story sums. Okay. Before that, keep these words in your mind. Okay. Total, all together, sum, in or plus. Any of these words will come in your question. You have to add the given questions. Okay, so children, is it okay? Now we are going to the examples. See, there are 6 lions. There are 6 lions. 2 more lions come along. 2 more lions come along. How many lions in total? See, listen the words more and in total. These words implies you have to add the given 2 numbers. What are the given numbers? 6 and 2. Now we are going to add 6 and 2. Are you clear, children? Read the questions 1 or 2 times. Make note of these words. These words means you have to add the given numbers. Are you okay, children? Add the numbers. Keep the number 6 in your mind and take 2 fingers, count forward. After 6, 7 and 8. We reach the number 8. Thus, there were 8 lions in total. Are you okay? Now we are moving to second example. I have 4 oranges. I buy 5 oranges more. How many do I have now? Listen the word. Make note of it. What's it? More. More means you have to add the given 2 numbers. What are the given numbers? 4 and 5. Now we are going to add 4 and 5 as usual. Keep the number 4 in your mind. Take 5 fingers in your hand. Add the numbers. What? Where do we reach? We reach the number 9. Thus, I have 9 oranges now. Are you clear, children? We have one more example. Geeta has 14 balloons. Ramya has 5 balloons. How many in all? Make note of it girl. What's it mean? In all means you have to add given 2 numbers. What are we going to do? We are going to add 14 and 5. Add as usual by counting forward. Keep number 14 in your mind. Take 5 fingers and count forward. After 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 and 19. What's the answer? 19 is answer. Thus, they have 19 balloons in all. Are you clear, children? I hope you all enjoyed the class. Now it's time to note the omer. After this